So here today with Barb Anness, who is running for state representative for the 45th district. How are you today?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. Thank you so much for doing this. Can you just tell us why you've decided to run for state rep?
Sure. I like to tell folks that my campaign was born out of a combination of frustration and optimism. I really love the community in which I live. I have not been very happy with the type of representation I've received in the 23 plus years that I've lived here, especially in the past 6 years. And I just see that the representation that I've been having hasn't been representing my values. So that's the frustrating part. As I said, I've lived in the community 23 years. I've spent the past 17 of them advocating for strong public education for all children in Michigan, including the district in which I live in. And I currently serve as the local school board trustee for Rochester Community Schools. So in both of those roles, I've seen over the years the type of representation that I've had, and it's been frustrating some of the decisions I've seen being made in Lansing and how they impact my local community. But I'm also optimistic. Because I live in a state that I know has had a great history and a great past, and I want to be a part of using my experience and my background and understanding my community the way that I do. I want to be a part of the changes that have to be made, because quite frankly, I think prior to what we've been dealing with COVID-19, we were at a crossroads as a state to begin with. So I want to be a part of those decisions being made at a state level that impact my community locally. And I want to be there to champion what works for my community, but I also want to be there to move the needle on policies that will move Greater Rochester and Michigan as a state forward.
So you talked about education as one of your priorities. What are some of the other things you want to work on if you get to Lansing?
Sure. Well, as I mentioned pre-COVID, it would be education at the top of the ticket for me, but I live in a community that has a really strong base of small business. I'm a small business owner myself. I'm a graphic designer by trade. And obviously jobs in the economy are a top issue in this state, and I think for my community as well. So I would continue to champion that and work for better outcomes for my community and the state in that area. Which I think will be all the more important moving forward and through this COVID pandemic crisis. The other issues that I'm passionate about, I'm really concerned about keeping our environment and our fresh water and our natural resources in Michigan protected. That is a priority for me as well. I'm also concerned about government transparency and making sure that government works for its citizens. Not only to help people stay informed, but to also give people a greater confidence in local, state, and federal government.
Now, you mentioned having been a small business owner and running your own graphic design firm. What are some of the other professional experience and skills that you bring to the table?
Well, actually, I've been a graphic designer my whole life. I graduated with a degree in graphic design. Worked in small businesses, larger businesses before moving to this area, and staying at home to raise kids, but had the flexibility to work out of my home with my career choice, which has been really awesome. But, you know, that process of being a designer helps inform my public role as a school board trustee. There's definitely a process as a designer that I use to problem solve and work with my clients. And it's that type of skill set that I continue to bring to my role in my public service as a school board trustee. And I would do the same at a state level if given the opportunity to serve as a state representative. Problem solving, collaborating, those types of things, bringing all folks to the table to have discussions about key issues. Because I won't pretend to know everything about everything. I think collaboration is really key in good government. So that's what I want to bring.
Now, in your time on the school board, what are you most proud of?
Wow. I would say preschool board as a citizen. I was involved in the bond initiative 6 years ago that passed a $185 million bond, which has been really gratifying to see the evolution of that public investment of our community in our school district. As a school board member, I was a part of a citizens committee that worked really hard to pass that bond. And then when the bond monies became available and were being implemented in the school district, I had the opportunity as a school board trustee to see the fruition of that investment, which that's been extremely, extremely fulfilling. We've been able to upgrade our infrastructure in terms of technology for our district. We've been able to shore up the security for our school buildings throughout the district. My involvement with the school board has also brought about the implementation of a orchestra strings program, which has been really fun to watch the growth of that. And we've also implemented a child care center, Caring Steps Learning Center, which has been part of our district now, and it's a way to continue to promote the positive agenda that public schools have, which is learning even from birth until you get to kindergarten.
Now, in this race, you do have some competition both in the primary and also in the November election. Why should the voters pick you?
Sure. So it's interesting. There are a lot of things in the primary that my competitor and I have in common, a lot of things that we have similar beliefs on. I think where we differentiate each other is my life experiences matter in terms of informing my perspective. I am the child of divorce. I was raised by a single parent. I'm married and I've lived in this community. And I'm a parent who has raised two children in this community. I'm a homeowner and a taxpayer, which I think is really important. That also gives you an interesting perspective. I'm currently a public servant through the local school board as a trustee. And I think I bring to this role a skill set of collaboration and problem solving through the public service experience that I currently have. And I run a small business in this community, and I think that perspective is also really key to informing someone else's perspective as well. It matters that you are able to see all of your constituents where they are and have empathy and compassion for the problems that they have so that you can help solve them.
So if voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Sure. So I have a website. It's barbanness.com. My last name is spelled A-N-N-E-S-S. So it's barbanness.com. And then I'm also on social media. You can check me out on Facebook at Barb Anness for State Rep. And then I'm also on Twitter and Instagram at barbanness2020. And I also am hosting a series during this time of COVID, a series of virtual community conversations every Saturday at 1 o'clock for an hour. And you're welcome to go to my website, barbanness.com, to sign up and register and be a part of the conversation virtually.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for doing the interview today.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.